Yeah, let's build a custom exception handler here. So for that purpose, I already created two classes. One is error DTO. DTO is nothing but a data transfer object, which is used to transfer a data to the view. So basically, we have some fields which are private. We don't want to pass it to the user. So at that time, we use a DTO. It's a view object basically. So we can transfer actual data which is get from database into the DTO with the help of getter and setter. Okay, so it's some other story. I can make the video on DTO to data transfer object. And I also created the another class. It's called global exception handler. Yeah, both classes are blank. Okay, so for that purpose, creating the global exception, I use the annotation called control advice. Okay, so this is the annotation I am going to use here. After that, I am sending a runtime exception from here. Okay, so this is the runtime exception I am sending from here. So I need to handle it here. So for that purpose, I am using the class name exception handler. Okay, so it's an exception handler which take the parameter as a class name basically. So we are handling runtime exception, so that's why I am putting runtime exception dot class. Okay, after that I am writing one method called public. I am sending the response entity, response entity from the error DTO class. Okay, error DTO class. Okay, so we are implementing error DTO in this method. Okay, so don't worry about it. Generate exception is the method name. Okay, so what this method take in the parameter, it's a runtime exception which is get a input, which is input of this method. Okay, runtime exception, it's a RE. Okay, so I am creating runtime. Now let's build a error DTO. I am using three field here. Okay, private string. Okay, private string timestamp. Okay, after that, what I need? I need a status. Sorry, I need a status. After that, I need a error message. Okay, okay, so I am using Lombok here. I have annotation called data. Okay, so it generate getter and setters. Okay, so we have ready our error DTO. Now we need to implement it inside our global exception handler. So I am creating error DTO here. It's a DTO is equal to new error DTO. So you can use a builder or you can use a constructor to create the object. It's your choice, but I love setters. So I am adding timestamp here. Add, I'm going to set timestamp. So with the help of new date, dot to string, okay, which give you a date in the string format. This is a timestamp I generated. After that, I need to add a status of that exception. Set a status, so I am using 500 for now. And after that, I need to add a DTO dot set message. Okay, so from where we are getting our message? Basically, we are using runtime exception as input here. So this runtime exception give you lots of parameter. It's a localized message, get message, to string, get cause. It's all kind of method which are present inside the exception class. Okay, so basically runtime exception inherit the exception class. So I'm using that method called get message. Okay, this is the method. Okay, so That's how we already created our DTO. Now we need to send it with a response entity class. So how we are going to send it? New. I need to write return new response entity. Okay, response entity, and I need to add a DTO here and a status. Okay, HTTP status dot internal server error. Internal server error. Okay, so this is how we are going to send our custom exception, because actual Spring Boot exception, it give you 5 parameter and long trace which is not readable. Okay, so that's how we are going to modify our actual exception. Now let's test it how it's working. Okay, application is up and running. I am sending exception. Let's see, your actual exception format get changes. Okay, so one advice for you, or one take a note, you can customize your exception whatever form you want. Okay, so for that purpose you just need to add some parameters here. Okay, so in this way you can implement your custom